Today we're going to take a look at upgrading the firmware of the IND360 using the built-in web server of the device. So here I am in Microsoft Edge, connected to the web server of IND360. And I can see here on my device page, I am not using the latest firmware here. So what I want to do is I want to go down to maintenance, and I want to go to update and backup. I have a few options here, and I want this firmware section. So I'm going to select choose, and I'm going to navigate to where I downloaded the firmware file onto my computer. Luckily, it's already right here available to me. So I'm going to double click the analog version. It's done a little check here to make sure it's compatible with my hardware. And since I have the green check mark, I'm going to proceed and hit update. So this will take potentially a couple of minutes for this firmware to complete. I would just recommend being patient here and keeping power on the device at all times. I definitely don't want to risk any damage to the device by pulling power in the middle of a firmware update. So we'll just let this run for a couple minutes, and we'll join you back when it's all done. Okay, so now as that update has completed, IND360 will prompt the restart of the terminal. I'm going to click OK, and the IND360 will automatically initiate that power cycle of the device. Like I said before, be patient with it. It might take a minute or two for it to run through the whole power cycle process. It will complete it though, so don't get too impatient and start pulling any power cables here. So as we wait for that to power cycle, we'll join you back when that's all started up again. Okay, so what we've done so far is update the main board of IND360. So if you've got the IND360 DIN mounted module, that's all you'll need to do. For the harsh and for the panel versions though, we also need to update the display board, which you'll be prompted to do when the unit finishes that automatic power cycle. So you can see here we are prompted for it on this panel unit. So I'm going to select yes with that central button, and then we will let this firmware update carry out. Depending on which version of firmware you have, this can take anywhere from 3 minutes to update up to about 20 or 25 minutes. So again, be patient here, and when it's all done, you will have a completely updated IND360 unit. All right, so now you can see our display board is also upgraded. So our main board is upgraded through the web server. Our display board was upgraded through the front panel of the device. Now, no matter which type of IND360 you have, it's always a good idea after a firmware upgrade to do a master reset of the device. If you've already set up the unit, this is a great time to take a backup of all the parameters so we can load that in after the master reset. If you don't know how to do that, you can see a separate video we have on how to carry that process out. But for now, on this device, I'm going to show you how to execute that master reset. So we're actually going to cut to another unit I have sitting on the table. So you can see this is that DIN-Rail IND360 that we have the same unit of in the panel mount display. This is just it removed from that display so we can see it a bit easier. Right by that web server port that we connect to the web server on, we also have two DIP switches here, switch 1 and switch 2. And we have two versions of a master reset we can do. We can do a master reset where we clear absolutely everything out of the unit back to factory defaults. That we would do by doing setting switch 1 to the on position. Now the on position is when it's pushed towards the white lettering on the outside. So switch 2 is on, switch 1 is off. That will clear everything, including our calibration adjustment data. If we want to save that because we've got a good calibration in there, we turn both switch 1 and switch 2 to on. What we're going to do today is we're going to do a full master reset. So we're going to leave switch 1 off and switch 2 on. So now we can cut back to our main unit here. So I've already done that with the DIP switches here. So what I'm going to do is, now that the DIP switches are in place, I'm going to briefly remove power to the device from the back. And then after a few seconds, I'm going to put power back on the device. We can see as it's going to come up, there will be a confirmation that the master reset was successful, and the W and M means that weights and measures associated parameters were also a part of that master reset. So I'm just going to hit that central button to clear it, and now you can see the unit is back up and running. What I'm going to do one more time is I'm actually going to set the dip switches back to their original state, and then I'm going to pull the power and power cycle it one more time. So that's just to make sure that the next time this unit gets power cycled, we don't master reset it once again. So you can see the unit has come back up. We've got some errors on the device because of some of the default settings we have in our system, but we can fix that potentially by that backup we could have saved before the master reset by loading that back in. But again, that's all covered in a different video. So that is how you carry out a firmware upgrade from start to finish on the IND360. Thank you so much for your time.